dominant repulsion theory. Two dominant alleles or recessive alleles occur in the same homologous chromosome tend to inherit together into same gametes are called as coupling or cis configuration. If a dominant allele or a recessive allele are present on the two different but homologous chromosome, they inherit apart into different gametes are called as repulsion or transconfiguration. We can better understand this theory by taking a simple example of sweet pea, which is scientifically known as Lathyrus odoratus. First, we will take the example of coupling or cis configuration. Herein, we cross the purple flower with long pollen, which is a dominant gene, with the red flower and round pollen. These are the parental generation. When a cross is made between these, both you can observe that they are homozygous parents. So this is the gamete formed from one of the parent, that is capital P, capital L, and another parent, small p and small I. In the F1 progeny, as you all know that it is the dominant alleles which show phenotypically, that is, herein it is purple flower and long pollen. But when you see the genotype, you can see that here it is having both dominant and recessive alleles, that is, it is heterozygous. When we come to a test cross, that is, you already know that test cross means, that is, we are crossing a recessive parent with a heterozygous parent. Herein, we are using the heterozygous F1 crosses with double recessive parent. So we are crossing this F1 here, and it is a double recessive parent, that is, it is having red flower and round pollen. So in the F1 gamete formation, these are the gametes which are formed, and here only a single gamete is formed because it is having only the recessive ones. So here you can see that it can be capital P, capital L, or it can be small p and small I, or it can be capital P and small I, or small p and capital L. So these are the various combination of gametes which can be formed. So this is forms the gametes and the F1 generation. When we fertilize these, what do we get in the F2 generation? Okay, we get capital P, capital L, and small p and small I. Okay, and here capital P, small L, and small p and small l. Next, small p, capital L, and small p and small l. Next, this is lastly, we find that small p, small l, and small p and small l. So these are the four combinations which we got from the F2 generation after crossing the F1 gametes. So you can see that purple long, red round is the parental generation what we took here. So what was the experimental result was, they got 44 of the parental characteristics, and of which 6 were completely different from the parent. You can see that this is a new combination which was not present in the parent. So the observed ratio was 7:1:1:7. But what was expected from the scientist was 1:1:1. That is, law of independent assortment was not followed. In the next example, we can speak about repulsion or transconfiguration. So here also the parental generation is, we have taken as purple flower, round pollen, red flower, long pollen. So you can see that purple flower is a dominant character, but round pollen is recessive. Here you can see that red flower is the recessive character and long pollen is the dominant. So now you can understand the difference between this, what we spoke earlier, and this picture, what you are seeing. See, kindly look at the alleles, how they are arranged and on which chromosomes they are present. So first the gamete formation will occur, and then in F1 generation, as usual, we know that it is the purple flower with long pollen what we obtain phenotypically. And genotypically, you can see that it is same as that of the parent. So when we do a test cross, that is, we have taken this purple flower and long pollen, whatever we got in the F1 generation, and we cross it with the double recessive parent here. So from this, we get 4 gametes. From this parent, we get 4 gametes, as you can see here. And since this is a double recessive, we can expect only one combination, that is red flower and round pollen, because we are taking the recessive parent. So when we make the following crosses, as I said before, in F1 generation, we get purple long, purple round, red long, red round. So here the observed ratio was 6:6. That is, they were exactly same as that of the parent. Whereas you can see here 44:44, which was a new trait which was observed. So that these were completely different from that of the parent generation. So we got 1:7:7:1, but the expected ratio was 1:1:1. So in the both the example, we saw that the expected ratio was 1:1:1, but what the scientists observed was it was a completely different picture. In coupling, we got majority of the phenotype looked like that of the parents, but in repulsion we saw that the majority were different from that of the parent. This clearly indicates that if you take this example, it clearly indicates that, see here we have got 44:44, which is similar to that of the parent. That is, we can say that these genes, that is red round, purple long, are present somewhere to close to each other, that they are inherited to the next progeny similarly. Whereas in transconfiguration, we saw that a new character, that is the purple round, red long, were in the majority, whereas the parental character were low in number, which clearly indicates that there has occurred a crossover or a repulsion in the genes. So what has happened, we can see the recombinant variety more in number when compared to that of the parental characteristics. Continuing with this, we shall study some more example, taking the example of drosophila and maize. So we shall first look into the example of complete gene in drosophila. Before we go into the example, let us look into few points of what do you mean by the theory of linkage. In linkage, the genes which show the phenomena of linkage are situated in the same chromosome. They are situated on the same chromosome, and these linked genes usually remain bounded by the chromosomal material so that they cannot be separated during the process of inheritance. So the distance between the linked gene determines the strength of the linkage. The closely located gene shows strong linkage than the widely located gene, which shows a weak linkage. And the genes are arranged in the linear fashion in the chromosome. So these are the points which you have to remember when it comes to linkage. That is what we meant to tell is, see, if this is a homologous pair of chromosome, if you go back to my previous videos also, I have explained this. If the genes are present close to each other, they will be tend to be inherited together. Okay, and you can see the distance between these two genes are not much. It is actually, you can say that they are very closely related to each other. And also the genes are arranged in a linear fashion. So these are the conditions, the three important conditions which are necessary for the complete linkage. So when we look into the example, herein I have given the example for the drosophila, which is showing us the complete linkage. So here you can see in this example, in Drosophila melanogaster, the fourth chromosome is very small. So you know that Drosophila has four chromosomes. Okay, so suppose say this is a chromosome, this if this is a four pairs of chromosome, you can see that the fourth chromosome, it's very small. The genes located in this chromosome are so closely arranged that they do not undergo any crossing over. Hence, independent assortment does not occur because they are so closely linked, they cannot assort independently. Whatever the genes are present on this chromosome, they cannot independently assort because they are linked together so closely. So for example, if the mutant gene BT, okay, which represents the bent wings, and SVN for the shaven bristles, that is reduced bristles on the abdomen, are known to be present on the fourth chromosome. So these two genes, since they are present in the fourth chromosome, which is very small, they are very closely linked to each other. And the other one in the wild type, so this is what mutant type, in the wild type, that is the normal, you can see that the alleles are represented as BT plus and SVN. Okay. So when a mutant bent shaven, it is crossed with the wild type, that is, which is having a normal type of body or the wings. When they cross, you can see that we get the wild type variety. Okay, so BT plus SVN, which was normal on one of the chromosome, and in another homologous chromosome of the same pair, we have the small BT and SVN, which is representing the bent shaven. Next, what we have to do? We have to go for a test cross. So whatever we got in the F1, this heterozygous is crossed with the recessive parent, that is bent shaven. So here you can see what happens is the gametes are formed. This is the normal gamete and this is the mutant gamete, which is crossed with the recessive parent. In the test cross, so when we do a test cross, this is what we get. What we got, you can see here, it is exactly same as that of the parent, that is the wild type. And here what happens, you can see that it is the mutant type, that is it is bent shaven. So it is 1:1. So you cannot see any new variety being formed. There is no variation. What was present in the parent genera, same thing you can see even in the progeny. This indicates very clearly that crossing over is not happening between these two parent. Whatever the female or the male parent genes were present, it was just passed on same to that of the progenies. So these are the gametes. Okay, so whatever the F1 I have got, the gametes are written here. So this forms one gamete, this forms one. Okay, here it is. And then what we are saying, we are crossing it with the recessive parent. You know what is recessive parent is, that is the bent and shaven. Because when you are telling wild type, means wild type means it is the normal variety. So what is the gamete formed here? It is only these, right? So look at this. When I cross this BT and this BT, I have got this. And SVN, same thing here, I have got. So there was no crossing over at all. Whatever was there in the parent generation, that is retained in the progeny, which clearly shows that it is a complete linkage. That means these two characteristic features are so close to each other that they cannot move apart from each other. They should be carried together. They move together only. So the next example we shall see of the incomplete gene in the drosophila. So herein you can observe that the parent gray body color, long wing. So this is the dominant genes which are present in the drosophila, and black body color and vestigial wing is the recessive variety. So here female, we have taken the dominant, that is gray body and long wing, and the male we have taken the recessive characters, that is black and vestigial wing. Vestigial wing means small wing they are. So we shall see that when Morgan mated the gray bodied with the vestigial winged fruit flies, with the flies having black bodies and normal wings, what happened? So these are the gametes which were obtained, the female gamete and the male gamete. So in the F1 generation, you can see that we got gray body color and the long wing. So that was obviously, as you know, that in the F1 generation we are always going to get the dominant ones. When it is crossed with the black body vestigial wing, that is what the parent now, that is the male parent, here we are doing a test cross. That is, in test cross, what did we tell? The F1 progeny is crossed with the recessive parent. Okay, the F1 progeny, this is your F1 progeny. It is crossed with the recessive parent. Then what are the combinations of gametes which we are going to get? Obviously, here it is going to be only the black body and the vestigial wing. No other go here. But what about this gray body color and the long wing? So it is a heterozygous. So you can see that the gray body along with the long wing. And here you can see that small b represents what? Black body, and small v is the vestigial wing. Okay, and this again capital B, we know it is a gray body, and small v is the vestigial wing. And here you can see capital V, that is means it is long wing, and here it is the black body. So these are the combinations we got. So here you can see it is written as non-crossover. Non-crossover means it is, they have same parental character. Okay, see, this BV is what you have obtained in, that was your parent, and this BV is another parent. Okay, a male and the female parent. But here you see this capital B and small v, small b and capital B, was this present in your parent? No. So here what has happened? Crossover has occurred. So you can see that the parental character, almost 83% of the phenotype were same as that of the parent. And here 17% did not resemble the parent. They were of new combination. So what do you understand by this? We can understand by this, that is, these, the gray and the black body, long wing and vestigial wing, are not linked together. They are present far apart in the gene. Hence what happened, crossing over has occurred between the parents, and we have got the recombinant phenotypes, that is the progeny, the young drosophilas which were formed were different from that of the parent, but 83% were same as that of the parent. So recombination had occurred here, whereas in the previous what you saw, it was just the same as all the progenies were same as the parent, 1:1. Okay, one was bent shaven, another one was the wild type. But here you can see that apart from the parent character, you have also got a recombinant variety. So one more example of incomplete gene only we shall study in maize. So here you can see that in the maize, we have taken the parent generation, which is colored full seed. And in the another parent is colorless and shrunken seed. So the crosses between the homozygous parent were made. So homozygous parent means, look at your both the chromosome are having colored and full seed, and your colorless and shrunken. So when the parent gametes are formed, obviously here we got colored and full seed, here we got colorless and shrunken seed. And then in F1 progeny, obviously we'll get the colored full seed, but it is in the heterozygous condition. Look at this, it is colored full seed, but they are in the heterozygous. So next what you have to do, right, the test cross you have to do. So test cross, what? F1 progeny is crossed with the recessive parent. Okay, this is my F1 progeny, what I got. What was it? Colored and full seed. But look at the genes. Is this and the same? No. Okay, there are heterozygous, not homozygous. And this is what? Same as that of your parents. This is same as that of your parent. Now, what can we expect from the test cross? So from the test cross, of course, here we have only small c and small s, but here you can see we can have a various combination as that of here you have observed. Okay, so here four gametes can be formed in this. So finally, we can see that the parental progeny was 48% dominant one and 48% recessive resembling the parent, and another 4% were the recombinant type, that is which you did not see in the parental variety. So what do you infer from this? Due to crossing over, recombinant progenies are obtained in the least number. So the parental characters are more number, but recombinant progenies were also formed. So in incomplete linkage, okay, or it is also called as partial linkage, we always observe that along with the parental characteristics, we also observe a new progeny. But in the linked gene, we do not see this. Okay, so what we saw that it was just whatever the parental features were there, that was exactly passed on to the progeny. So let us know what is the significance of linkage. So the significance of linkage is, this is a phenomenon of which has a great significance as it reduces the possibility of variability in gametes. Okay, suppose say I don't want any variation, whatever example a plant, okay, I want the same type of plant throughout and I don't want any recombination to occur. In that cases, we can follow this linkage. But suppose say that no, I want a new variability which is different, okay, then we can go for the crossing over, because in crossing over, what did we observe? There is always a formation of the new variety. In linkage, there is no formation of the new combination. So linkage, the genes present on the chromosomes stay close together, whereas in crossing over, it leads to the separation of the linked gene. Why? Because here the genes are not present close to each other, they are present far apart. Okay, and see, if they are present in far apart, so what can happen? There can occur a crossover and it can lead to a new recombination. It involves the same chromosome of homologous chromosome here. It involves exchange of segment between the non-sister chromatids of the homologous chromosome. So hopefully there is no confusion between the sister and non-sister chromatids. Okay, suppose say if these two are homologous, these two are homologous, these are the sister chromatids, but this and this are non-sister chromatids. So it linkage, it reduces new gene combination. There is no formation of new combinations here. In crossing over, obviously it increases the variability of forming a new combination. So what happens? It leads to the formation of new organisms. So we have taken the example of maize and drosophila to study about the linkage and the crossing over. Apart from this, we also saw what the definition, okay, what do you mean by the cis configuration and trans configuration? What is the cis form? That is the coupling and the repulsion here. So now let us conclude. Like if you see my previous videos on these linkages and crossing over, we had asked a question that is independent assortment is wrong or what. And we also found the answer that telling that no, it is not so. Okay, it is not wrong. Independent assortment by Mendel is also correct, but this type of patterns do occur, like complete linkage and incomplete linkage also occurs. That is what T.H. Morgan has showed. So if you look carefully, you can understand the difference between the independent assortment, complete linkage, incomplete linkage, or it is also called as partial linkage. So in partial or incomplete linkage, here what happens is two genes are so close on the same chromosome that recombination occurs less than 50% of the time. See here, whatever we have seen. Okay, the two genes are close on the same chromosome that recombination occurs less than 50%. Okay, you can see that very clearly. It was the recombination has formed, but it is less than 50%. That is known as the incomplete linkage. That is telling that though the genes are little close, but not as close as the complete gene. So in complete linkage, what happens? Two genes on the same chromosome are so close that recombination cannot separate them, because they are so closely linked that you cannot separate them. They will be inherited together. And what is the independent assortment tells? The independent assortment is telling that there is complete recombination occurring, right? So here, the two genes on the different chromosome or different genes, two genes on the same chromosome are far apart, that recombinant occurs 50% of the time. So if you take the, if you recall the dihybrid cross, we saw that the 9 is to 3 is to 3 is to 1. That what happened, that recombination, whatever the new progeny you've got, it was 50% the new variety. But in incomplete linkage, though there is recombination occurring, it is less than 50%. In complete linkage, there is no question of recombination at all. So all these three are present. It is true. Okay. Independent assortment is also there. Incomplete linkage also occurs in nature, and complete linkage also. But complete linkage is very rare, as I told you earlier also. You can rarely see in drosophila and silk moth, okay? But incomplete linkage and independent assortment, we can see in different organisms.